I would like to address a little bit Dr. Leon. I call him Man, their close family friend, and he is the pioneer of this hospital. I was a member of the union when we bought this property. And this is also my first time to stand before you in this public. What a privilege, isn't it? For how many years? This is my first time to study the words of God together with the workers of Davao Adventist Hospital. This is a privilege and it is a happy moment in my life that I will be studying with you a very, very important words of the Lord. Isn't it? Do you agree with that? Okay. As announced, I worked 41 years in the denomination, 20 years here in the Philippines, and 21 years in America, and this will be my 30 years in America. It was a very, very long years of service and long years of stay in a beautiful country. But when I signed my retirement, my brethren, when I signed my retirement, and this is, you will be approved, Pastor, oh, my heart fly over to the sky. I am happy. At last, I reach my goal. Not only that, I am happy because I retired in the North American division, not in the Philippine money, but it is the green money. Oh my! My being a poor boy, it was compensated when I signed that I will be receiving not Philippine money, but a green money. Praise the Lord, isn't it? It's a blessing, isn't it? Oh, if you are in my place, you will do the same. You will fly over the air and sing hallelujah. Praise the Lord, isn't it? Okay. I would like to read some quotations from the writings of Ellen White. It says in Great Controversy, page 458, in mercy to the world, okay? In mercy to what? To us, to the world. Jesus delayed his coming. Are you happy? Are you happy that Jesus delayed his coming? Or no? You like that he will come now? Okay, come on. Think it. Put it in your mind. Are you really happy that Christ delayed his coming? Or are you happy that he is coming soon? That is what Ellen G. White said. In mercy to the world, Jesus delayed his coming, that sinners may have an opportunity to hear the warning of his coming. I am standing before you this morning, my beloved, to give you the warning that is written in the secret word of God. In Chinese, we have the belief that we have three important parts of the year. Of the 12 months of the year, we have a very, very important month, January, February, the month of March, just a week ago. We are now in April 8th. And March is the last New Year of the Chinese people. And we have also recalled that Lamism. Lamism is a course of happiness and life management. That's why you know who controls the economy of the Philippines. Chinese. Who controls the economy in South America? Mga Espanyol. Chinese. I have been there. A lot of Chinese who spoke the Spanish language. In America, the same. The control, the economy of the Philippines. That is what we call Lamism in Chinese, a course of happiness and life management. And last year, they called that year Monkey Year. It's a year of miracles. Do you agree? It's a year of miracles because what happened to the Philippines? Mayor Rodrigo Roa Duterte ascendancy to the presidency of the Philippines, being only a mayor, and then he jumped over to be the president of the Philippines. Is that not a miracle? And then Great Britain breaking off from the European Union. Cut off. And the bigger one, the biggest of the miracles of the year of the monkey was the President Donald Trump victory as a president. That is a miracle. How come that he became a president while in fact the polls is always telling Mrs. Clinton is always ahead? And when the final time Trump came in, it is a miracle. Is there a miracle happening in your life? Yes. I am happy Mrs. Leon is here with us. He got a stroke for a long time and you are still alive and happy. Praising the Lord during Sabbath in the place where your husband dedicated his life to be a worker as a doctor of this hospital. It's a miracle, isn't it? It's a miracle. In Matthew 19, verse 26 says, but Jesus looked at them and said to them, with man, this is impossible. Isn't it? This is like, this, if man, even your husband is a doctor, that is still impossible. If it is not God's plan that you are alive today. We are happy that we are alive today, my beloved. What happened in Colombia today, last week? There was a much flash all over Colombia, and there were more than 300 people died while we are here seeking pity. It's meaning the order of the Dorian round. Are you not happy? Yes, you are happy, my brother. This is impossible thing happening if without the mercy of God. Beloved and brethren, remember the word of God. Who among you is reading your Bible daily? I hope you are. Mrs. White is very, very clear in telling us that it is well for us to spend a thoughtful hour
Do you hear me? Do you hear me? But this is why it tells us in Desire of Ages, page 83, it would be well for us to spend a thoughtful hour every day meditating upon the Word of God. What can you get out of the Bible? What is the Bible, by the way? From here, you could study 22 books of the Bible are historical. That's why we'll come later on at the end of our study, a history about the flood that happened in this world, my beloved. 21 are largely book of prophecy. We will also study what the writers of the Bible prophesied, what will be happening, what will be, what will be done in the political side of the world, or religious affiliation around the world. 21 are the forms of letters from here, and 2 are primarily poetic, the book of Psalms and Proverbs. This is a very important book we have. But yet, I saw many books. If I visit homes, are dusty, never touched. In a week, you just pile your Bible in your salad or in your bookshelf without opening it. It is very dusty. But Mrs. White told us, please spend thoughtful hour in reading the Word of God. Now I will give you a warning. A warning. Who separated from Catholicism into Protestantism? Who lived the movement of protesting against the Catholic Church? You remember? History, my beloved. Who started the movement against Catholicism? It was Martin Luther. And what year did he start it against the Catholicism? It was September 500 years ago. What is that? What year is that? 500 years ago. Jesus Christ was born, what? 480, and how many years now? Okay, the Protestantism, my beloved, 500 years ago, Martin Luther started against the Catholic Church. That was 500 years ago, and now what is happening? This coming September, it will be my birthday, and I will never forget. I read that in the newspaper. That the Protestant and Catholicism will unite and sign a document that they will end the Protestantism. What will be happening? What will be the situation of the world when we have only one religion? And who will be only against the Catholic? It's only one. Who? We, the Seventh-day Adventists, will be against only for the Catholic Church. You know, it says here, after this unity document is signed, there will be no more Protestant denomination. You see that? No more Protestant. No more Methodist. No more Iglesia de Cristo. What more? No more. What will be the Seventh-day Adventist that will stand all against the Catholic?
the eye of the world will be on the Seventh-day Adventist, because we shall be the only denomination to refuse the Babylonian unity that is found in Revelation 12:17. And the dragon was wroth with the woman and went to make war with the remnant of her seed, which kept what? The commandments of the Lord and have the testimony of the Lord Jesus Christ. It's only to so keep the commandments and the spirit of prophecy and who believe on this truth. It's only we, Seventh-day Adventist Church. I don't have it. Time is coming. The ecumenical movement. Revelation 16, verse 13. And I saw three unclean spirits like frogs coming out of the mouth of the dragon, out of the mouth of the beast, and out of the mouth of the false prophet. The ecumenical movement has been going on for decades. It was signed by President Carter. It was signed by President Clinton. It was signed by President Bush. We are just only waiting for the implementation of Sunday law. What happened now? What is going on now? I will show you something that is. Somebody gave this to me, but I don't know whether this is true or not, but we will see. There is somebody who the picture of President Trump, and there is a note that he wrote over here and says, every Sunday is now designated National Day of Prayer for Saint Trump. Anyone who refuses to observe Sunday will be rebaptized, waterboarded, or sent to jail for 3 years. I don't know if this is true or not. There are many people who are wise to make announcement like this. But to me, even this is not true or not, my beloved, this is a reminder to us. This is a warning to us. Because of the prophecy that was mentioned by Ellen G. White, that Sunday law will soon to come. You like it or not, my beloved? You like it or not? Sunday law. Ellen G. White wrote in 1885. How many years ago? It says here. Ellen G. White wrote in 1885, Testimonies for the Church, Volume 5, page 451. When Protestantism shall stretch her hand across the Gulf to grasp the hand of the Roman power, okay? When she shall reach over the abyss to clasp hands with spiritualism, when under the influence of this threefold union are contrary to the United States government and shall repudiate, means refuse, if a principle principle of the Constitution. What is in the Constitution, my beloved, of the United States? Separation between religious and state. But these, according to Mrs. White, they will make a provision that later on they will change the Constitution. The propagation of the papal falsehood and delusion, that we may know that the time has come for the marvelous working of Satan, and that the end is near. Now, my question is, how do we know that the end is near? How do you know, my beloved? We have been reading our Bible. Kita mga Pinistan, doon na. Na ito ba? Okay, doon na. Na ililog, doon na. Na isunami, doon na. Di ba? Yeah, that is what we are only 16. That is what I've been hearing even when I was born. When I was 2 years or 3 years old. Because I was born a Seventh-day Adventist. I know when there is flood, this Christ is coming. When there is war, Christ is coming. Now I am 76 and Christ has not come yet. Di ba? Natikubang na lang ito mo, apang ang gilapon. Ang sabi na ito pagkalo, na doon na ito bumalik ang gilapon. How? Ah, nagadugay na tayo na ta, basa sa Bible ito. Sama na ito pagkabaho ba? Isulti mo sa malang kasulat ng sabat. Okay, ang isulti sa malang kasulat ng money. When Jesus was sitting on the Mount of Olives, the disciples came to him privately, secreto. Kill us, Lord, he said. When will this happen, and what will be the sign of your coming? Do we know that? Ang sign to pag sigino. Jesus answered, watch out that no one deceive you. For many will come in my name, claiming I am the Christ, and will deceive me. Okay? Dahil dahil mo musima sa ato organization, sinungluwe, dagan niya di pasarap. Si Pastor Arangis, written 9, nagkita mi, sa mili kay Sol Mayo, ay nagkita mi sa di pasarap nagbalik. Nagpabotis mo back to the organization. Iko na ko, no. Parinti siya at masawa. No. Yung sa nalang nimo, katong imong gipang pasalaan na daghan kayo ng mga tao sa Mindanao, may nag-retin na yun. Tapos mo kung siya yung tubag. Course. Sila nalang kung bahala. Bumalik sila sa Ginoo. Ako, balik ko sa magpabotis mo. Is that enough? Ni ito nagkuha sa ilalim, so, nubalhin, pagkaritinayin, araw na din nakamagalagan sa denomination sa Seventh-day Adventist. Is that easy as that? Na ito nagpasta, so. Every thought, manalo sa inyong mortok, so, of what is in your heart, you will be judged. When Jesus Christ will come. Di ba? Kita. Magkasasala man tayo. But I am happy that the Lord is very, very kind. Clean by the Holy Spirit. Nagatanggap sa ating kasing-kasing. Balik, Pastor Pugayong, ikaw na yamag-yamag na. Balik, pag-alagat, magpating umalim ka. Tayo na bumalik. That is what the Holy Spirit is pleading every time, my brother. But how can the Holy Spirit works within us when we don't even listen to the voice of the Holy Spirit? Yeah. Maybe today you are attentively listening to the words of God through me. But in heart and in your mind, my beloved, are you really sincere? Are we really faithful? On an annual visit meeting, you will hear of words and rumors of words, but see to it that you are not alarmed. Okay? Ayaw magka-alarm. Such thing must happen, but the end is still to come. Okay, Lino, should we? Goto, kamatay, ang sabay, so, dilipa, diay mo, ang katapusan. It's still to come. So, sa mga diay katapusan, so. Okay, kita mo ay, pero sa mga diay katapusan, na naman ay inigtay, so, Goto, Lino, kamatay, oh, bilang ka mga tao na drug sick, that 177,000 according to the president ang affected sa drug sick, dagan pa ang patulo? Dagan pa? Ay kontra magunyan ng mga pusher, so. You know what happened? He can even promote those people who kill as long as they kill the drug pusher. And now he has the absolute power to pardon and promote somebody. Pero kanang nagbimanggo, bisan amigo ni John Arturo, there were already 92 people under him when he became the president. Tika, amigo of Kumdili. That is the right person to stand as a leader of his country. Now what happened more? All these are to be beginning of birth pain. Kini malino, gotong, away, mo parang ni sinugdel na iso. Tayo sa pamanyay, matapos ang buhay sa wind. Lipon lang tayo sa simbahan. Yeah, it's good. You have a comfortable place to stay. You have the air conditioner, 1, 2, 3, 6 air conditioner presses in your electric fan. You are comfortably in his church. But what is the command of the Lord, my beloved? Go and sit down in a comfortable air conditioned church. No? I say, go. So when you go. And so I go, Exxon, you need to move. You move to stand where you are sitting down right now. Go and what? Preach and what? Teach and what more? Go and make friends. Go, teach, preach, and make friends. Sometimes, our 21 years in America, you cannot baptize anybody in America unless you go and visit in their home. Evangelistic meeting, no one will attend. He's spending much money, but very few who will attend. So what you need? Ang akong ginahimo, I was appointed to be a member of the Union Executive Committee of POC because we baptized in Waterman Visayan Seminary and Adventist 47 precious souls one time. So, na will learn kung matrix on na maayo ng evangelist. Ano yung kiyakorporan sa iyo? Abong conference na may membro ko sa executive sa union. So, I'm the first Filipino to be a member of the Union Executive Committee. Ingon pa ni Pastor Jose, bright ka tingali Pastor. No, I am not a bright person. My wife could witness it. I am very, very, very not bright. No. But if the Lord will use you, my what you read to man, it is what? Impossible. But to God, nothing is impossible. Do you believe it?
Yeah, everything. To the Lord.
Now, for us to study clearly so that you will understand the nearness of the coming of the Lord. As I mentioned a while ago, that the Bible part is historical, part is prophetic, part are leaders. And now here we go to the prophetic sign of what the Bible is telling us. While you are there at Rome while ago, pagkahugaw ng ating Bible lesson, kasi hindi ko kabasa ang verses. Kaya no, I am a very slow learner. So what I need is to make notes in my Bible so that anywhere when the assignment is picked, I could stand and study and preach the Word of God because I have many notes in my Bible. I'm not a sharp guy. And the Lord maybe is giving me a guide what to do. Bisan hugaw-hugaw ka na ng Bible lesson, pero mali pa rin lang sa bukan. Kung Tagalog pati, I will never reach it. I promise to the Lord, Pastor, Lord, mag-retire ako, pero any appointment in this church, I'm the one. As long as you give me a little time. I dedicated my time, my friends. When I retired, I bought a car just for to visit different churches around here in Mindanao. Kinsa ba yung taga-America wanted rin magbalik sa akin ng gabi ito niyo. But no, different ang ako. No balik yung son, kami bisita ko sa nagkalanan ng English exam. I have another schedule in Kinabawan. I have another schedule in Pagadian exam. But I will go. What I gasto sa mission, it's my own expense. As long as I can do. Because I promise to the Lord, help me. Only give me strength. Mag-edad lang kong 76, bisan mag-edad pa kong 90, gamit ako ginoon, bisan magkurog-kurog ang kumot, iwanin ako ang iyong ngalan. And that is our contract with him. You know what happened to Noah during the flood? He preached how many years? 120 years. Iwala gino, iwali, Noah. Nga mabot ang lunok, mabot ang lunok, pero mabot ang 120 anos ito. O sa mga klasis ng warning? Is it a warning? Yeah, warning. Pero sa ka short period of time, no? It's a long period of time warning. Ito. Grabe. Kinsa ba'y naging meter sa inyo exam? Okay. Namatay ang anak ni Pastor Villarin, which is ang siya before yesterday. Boboy. Pastor Legon, the youngest son of Pastor Villarin. Ilobong Ugma. So how could we go? It's too close, warning. But then my wife is interested to go. Maybe I will go after this. Just to be present with them, to comfort them in their sorrows. Mamaya itong matayan. Pity the orphan, the widow, the sorbirin. Wala. Iksan, di dito magdalo sa itong panaw. We need to share. O na kining warning niya gihatag sa Diyos kang Noah and John is a very, very wrong warning. The invitation sa mo, so, nagigon atong chaplain na rin nga merili man yung to. Pero na ko, I'm sorry, there's somebody who invited us a birthday party of our beloved sister who was struck 3 years ago. Buhi pag-iakon. Sister Ipalina,
ibangkarat, magbubuhay karon ng nawa. Jismanito, nagahigda si Mumbai for 3 years. Kung kamo na ang sitwasyon niyo, what will you say to the Lord? Nung sakali inyong ibagurbon sa Ginoo niyo, kung tumutagaan, kung tulog at doon yung gandili pagkanyo, di alam ka sa katri, so? It is hard, my beloved. It is hard. The question is, do you believe it? Ibang ihatag ba ang ibang total dependency sa Ginoo, so? There will be done, mga ang apo nato sa Ginoo, so? There will be done. It's a terrible word. But yet, Jesus Christ told Noah, okay, Noah, go. And after the Bible's night, it's already done. Okay, bring all the animals into the ark and the little get in. What happened? But so only Noah. Because God is in control. What did God do to Noah while he was there in the ark? He and the servant exon ang purtahan na nobody could open. Even the people are shouting outside, Noah, please open the door. I cannot do anything, even in Noah. It is God. Time will come. This will be repeated again, my beloved. That's why this is a warning to us, my beloved. This is a warning. So here, Noah get in, and what happened? Giserhan sa Diyos, ang manarunda, ang porta, nobody could open it. Nobody could open it. And then what happened? For 7 days, sa inyo ito po, nagtantangan ito ba? The coming King is the Lord. What happened? Nagulangan niya. Ever since nga natukod ang kalibutan, walay ulang niya. So you see the idea there is that people really delusion, divide of the people, nga buwan po ang sinuwa, kay never nga ang langit nagulang. O na nagandang buong baruto, so, only the sword bag in there. Who will believe it? No one will believe it. That's why man, according to what the Bible says, is impossible. But to God, it is possible. Then rain came in for 7 days. What happened? The sword of my tongue, but now, no, no. For 40 days and 40 nights, padayo na ulan ni John, o nalulo ang kalibutan. What happened? Next. Nagkunhog ni John. Then later on, nabot ang mga. Ang Noah's opinion, people. Isipan niyo, of all the world, magkaisalang walulang ang nanuwas. It's very, very hard to compare the time of Noah and our time. Because all of us are enjoying life comfortably. Di ba? Happy tanan na nanay kotse, happy tanan na nanay balay, happy tanan na nanay bulbos, happy tanan na nanay lipstick, happy tanan na nanay puti sa ilay. O nanapay magpagwapo, ipataas pang ilaw ang uban na namatay na. Di ba iso? Kinsa ka rin itong babayaran nga, bago lang na namatay na under the operation sa pagpag-nuslip. We have all the money that we need. But it is time for us to prepare because this is time
that sinners may have an opportunity to hear the warning. That's why this is a warning for us. Basahin niyo rin, nakita na ko ito sa remote. I don't know if you get it. It's there at the back. It was pasted at the back, my beloved. When I passed by it, I say, oh, this is the one that was written by anyone. In mercy to the world, Jesus delayed his coming, that sinners may have an opportunity to hear the martyr. Oh, I'm happy, my friends, as I mentioned a while ago, that this is my first time to stand before you, that we acted this property, that it will be bought by the organization, by the rich people here at the corner. And they're happy to give this property. This is a 5 meters. I don't know what happened. Okay, now, what is that? What is that preparation to the part of Noah? O kini ang ginatawag sa Griko as suntalia. Suntalia, paminaw ito, suntalia is a long time period. The 120 years na nag-sermon, nag-wale, sinuwa, that is in Griko, suntalia ito, but that is a preparation for the coming of the flood. Long term. Okay, mag-long tagalan siya. Ito tayo mga long term o short term na mga tayo. Ako, nakawakal ko siya at gamit ko ng barko. Paano na lang kayo nakapag-lady ako ko sa kalong ito, nipuli na ako sa akong mata. Ay paro kami ng millions ito at tokong na akong mga building niya na bangkarot ako ito kay panilan na mga sa bangko na po kayo interest ang akong 2.8 million na harahapin naman na ito 5 million. What will I do? Diyan ang maning mo na ginawa sa ako. O niya karoon, babangkarutan, babangborot din ako. Siya ang kalutin mo sa matina. It's good that somebody, Saint Bedroor, na naibsar ka babae na nurse sa Dubai, so na iyang mama is from Kinabawan, he was interested and saw my brother and devoted, so he was able to bayan kayo ka. That is short term. Long. Ayaw mo pagkutan ito. Ayaw. No. According to my nephew who owns a bank in Cagayan de Oro, 80% ang di makabayan. You know that? I am one of them. 80%. Ayaw pagkutan. Samot na kung mamutan mo bank ko nga, you use it for pagwapos mong balay, for nature, by the God saying, you don't put it into business. Never. I advise you. Never. Bubangkarot mo. Okay, that is the long-term warning of the Lord that the flood is coming. That is what suntalia is. S-U-N-T-A-L-I-A. Suntalia. Okay, on sa naman ang pagsulot ni Noah na ito, it's 7 days. What is that in Griko, example? Okay, sa Griko, na pinulong ng Telos. Telos is the 7 days na nusulong si Noah sa arka. So, there are 2 things. So, Telia is the long term of Telos, ang short term, 7 days. All in about ang ka. So, the coming of the Lord is already in Telos time. But we don't know whether this is the first day, second day, third day, 40, 50, 6 days, or 7 days. Usually in the Bible, 7 days is a complete number, my beloved. 7 days is a complete number. And this is the church, according to the wife, Meluasa Trina. Wala! Dili nang gugawas sa 7 days. Ay mga pastor ninyo, dali sa Davao, nang gugawas na kibog kahit religion isa. That will never go. I tell you the truth. Only the 7 days Adventist is, even though it's in fever, umahuya, but this is the church that God is watching, looking, And this will stand up, and God will bring us to heaven. My beloved, I believe that victory is soon to come. It's soon to come. I know, because we are assured, my beloved, by Jesus Christ, who died on the cross, isn't it? Are you happy that Jesus Christ died on the cross? Yes, in fact, Satan has already been defeated at the cross, my beloved. No more. Satan cannot do anything, because there on the cross was demonstrated the undying love of God. There on the cross was where the unspeakable love that showed to humankind, my beloved. There on the cross was where the special Bible verse was unfolded, revealed, and explained in John 3:16, for God to love the world. There on the cross was there. We are able to see that everlasting love, even behind the sorrow of life, even behind pain, even behind sickness, and even behind death, my beloved. So what more? What more do we need? Yes, it's not only in the dying of Jesus Christ that complete our salvation, my beloved, but it is also in the resurrection of Jesus Christ. Resurrection morning will give us hope, my beloved. Resurrection morning brings eternal liberty to the saints. Resurrection morning will bring liberty from our enemies. Resurrection morning will reunite our loved ones that have been separated by them. Resurrection morning will give us the privilege to meet Adam and Eve, and above all, hope, Jesus Christ. That is why, that is how, in that person. My beloved, it is time that we are this morning. Mean, work in your mind. Remember what the Lord says. I search the mind and examine the heart. May God bless us that we remain true and faithful to Him. May God bless you.
People who may otherwise never know of Jesus can hear only about gift in our own language. By giving, we have a special opportunity to help share God's words to hope and love. Your love is appreciated. Thank you for systematically giving to the Lord's works so that the world visually can grow and help to reach a world in need. Hardy Collins is getting to pulling the touch of the brain.
Thank you.
Shall we bow our heads for a word of prayer? The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord turn his face towards you and give you peace. For the Lord your God will be with you wherever you go. Amen.
Now let's go to the announcements immediately.
Let us go to the Anti-Row